Good morning, everybody. Father Wade here. I think we started right. Yeah. Okay, I'm just making sure that live. I'm actually talking to somebody. Well, I've talked to myself before, anyways. Thank you for joining us, my friends. We're here for morning prayer of Holy Thursday, Thursday of Holy Week, and what do you? We're getting our acts together. We're all a little bit punchy because we have a little bit more sleep than usual, and. It's good to be able to, as we prepare to celebrate the Triduum, to join together in the Divine Office and the Liturgy of the Hours, to still to consecrate our day in worship and in prayer to Almighty God, and to really prepare ourselves. The Liturgy of the Hours is really one of these great treasures of the Church that certainly has been very influential in my own prayer life, teaching me the different ways of what it means to be somebody who is of the faith that is filled with the Word of God. And it's been really helpful in teaching me how to pray. And I hope that for those of you for whom this is a new experience, that you're able to see the beauty in it and able to appreciate how wonderful it is to be able to pray the Psalms, the same prayers that Christians have been praying for 2,000 years, the same prayers that Jesus and Mary prayed, and the same prayers that God's holy people have prayed since he revealed himself to them. So that's about enough, because I need to get to the back. Thank you for joining us, my friends.
God, come to my assistance.
Lord, make haste to help me.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Down its walls, it is blocked by all who pass
midst is the Holy One of Israel. You will draw a broad bridge from the springs of salvation.
We see Jesus crowned with glory and honor because he suffered death, that through God's gracious will, he might taste death for the sake of all men. Indeed, it was fitting that when bringing many sons to glory, God, for whom and through whom all things exist, should make their leader in the work of salvation perfect through suffering. By your own blood, Lord, you have brought us back to God.
By your own blood, Lord, you have brought us back to God.
from every tribe and tongue and people and nation. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
The Father anointed Christ with the Holy Spirit to proclaim forgiveness to those in bondage. Let us humbly call upon the eternal priest.
You went up to Jerusalem to suffer and so enter into your glory.
Bring your church to the Passover feast of heaven.
You were lifted high on the cross and pierced by the soldier's lance.
Heal our wounds.
You made the cross the tree of life.
Give its fruit to those who know.
On the cross, you forgave the repentant thief.
Forgive us our sins.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. God of infinite compassion, to love you is to be made holy. Fill our hearts with your love. By the death of your Son, you have given us hope, born of faith. by his rising again, fulfill this hope in the perfect love of heaven, where he lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.